Okay, so let's start today class. Today we are going to discuss some another topics of the electrical machine with three phase induction motor. Okay. So let's try to see in the previous topics discussion of single phase transformer, a lot of things you may be find out similar to three phase equivalent circuit and three phase induction motor equivalent circuit and transformer single phase transformer equivalent circuit. Various parameter are you may be find out common. Okay, so as well as the operating principle may be based on the same principle that is Faraday law of electromagnetic induction. So just try to do to be some basic construction difference. Okay. You just try to see the three phase induction motor. So just first of all share the screen and then we will continue our discussion. Okay, so 14, 8, 21. And topic is your three phase induction motor, three phase induction motor. So first of all, try to discuss about what is the introduction of three phase induction motor. What is how they can try to operate? How torque will you produce? So first of all, we just try to go through the introduction part of the induction motor. Okay, so introduction let me see. Polyphase induction motor is known as singly excited AC machine. Okay, singly excited AC machine in the sense that it is supplied power from a single AC source. Singly excited means supply given by the single AC source. Okay, that's why it is known as the singly excited machine. So first of all, this type of machine, a polyphase induction motor induction motor is singly excited AC machine is known as singly excited AC machine. Excited AC machine. In the sense that it is supply power from a single AC source voltage. Supply power power from a single AC source. Single AC source. Source. Whereas its rotor winding receives its energy from the stator by means of the induction. Okay. Whereas It's rotor winding. It's rotor winding. Receive energy receive its energy from a stator by means of induction from a stator by means of induction or you may be say that by the transformer action is similar to that one, is it not? So transformer action, that means energy transfer from one winding to another winding by the induction effect. Okay, so transformer action. Balance phase current current in polyphase winding winding produce a constant amplitude rotating MMF wave. Produce a constant amplitude rotating MMF wave. Amplitude rotating MMF wave. MMF wave. The stator produce MMF wave. The stator produce MMF wave. And rotor produce MMF wave. And rotor produce MMF wave. Both rotate in air gap in the same direction. Both rotate in air gap. Air gap in the same direction. In the same direction. direction at synchronous speed. These two MMF wave are the stationary with respect to each other. These two MMF wave are the stationary with respect to each other consequently the development of a steady electromagnetic torque torque is possible at all speed but not at synchronous speed. Synchronous speed. The stator and rotor MMF wave combine to give the resultant air gap flux wave. The stator and rotor MMF wave combine to give the resultant air gap flux density wave. The resultant air gap flux density wave of constant amplitude and rotating at synchronous speed and rotating at synchronous speed. Since an induction motor cannot run at synchronous speed, that's why it is called asynchronous machine. Is not? So, since an induction motor cannot run at synchronous speed. It is called asynchronous machine. That's why it is called. That means one winding again place here, that is known as two parts. That means one is your stator, another is your rotor. Okay, so one winding placed at the stator, another winding placed at the rotor. Okay. So EMF induced in both the winding, that means stator winding as well as in the rotor winding. Okay, so their resultant air gap MMF wave, that means stator and rotor, okay, combined to give the resultant air gap flux density wave. That means stator and rotor part are separated from the air gap, very small amount of air gap. Okay. You may be familiar with the construction of the three-phase induction motor, similar to the stator part, rotor part, what are the component consists. That means two winding placed, one is at the stator and another is at the rotor. Okay. So according to their rotor structure, you may be classified three-phase induction motor in two types. Okay. One is the squirrel cage induction motor, another is your slip ring type induction motor. So I think this classification of construction of we already covered in the previous classes also. So you may be that follow on your construction part. Okay, so you may be construction part follow from the that portion also. Okay, so basically, you may find out some basic similarity between the transformer and the induction motor. So just we try to, if you consider a stator winding and rotor winding, just similar like to the transformer primary and secondary winding, is it not? So when you supply given to the here in the winding placed at the stator, that means EMF will be induced in the stator as well as in the if you rotor winding kept open circuit, then it will also induce EMF in the rotor winding, but do not produce the torque because the circuit is open. So electromagnetic torque do not produce, but the EMF will be produced due to the flux cutting action. Okay, so just we try to see here what is the similarity between the induction motor and transformer. Okay. So induction motor, maybe find out similar just here. Induction motor. You may be remember their EMF induced in the winding of the primary and secondary of the transformer. So that EMF again induced to seems equation will be can we use here. That means 4.44, if you remember that the EMF induced in the primary and secondary coil. So 4.44 F1 N15, is not? So just induction motor of it as a transformer. So as a transformer, former So, and induction motor is similar to transformer in many respects. And induction motor is similar to a transformer transformer in many respect in this connection consider an induction motor with both its stator and rotor winding in a star. Okay. Consider an induction motor and induction motor with both its stator and rotor winding in a star with rotor winding in a star. I think you are familiar with the three phase connection either in a star or delta form. Okay. So three winding will be connected in such a manner if you connect it in a star, that means one is your neutral point and three will be provided for the three phase. That means either you may be in culture A, B, C or R, Y, B, whatever you may be want. Okay. Similarly, the secondary side, you may be three phase. That's why you may be connected in a star or delta form. Okay. So you have knowledge, I think, about the connection of three phase in a star or delta. Okay. So we just consider here that the stator and rotor winding are connected in a star where the three phase rotor in a star. Okay. So in such a manner that single phase winding will be connected in a star or delta. Okay. So you may be obtained line to line voltage and line to phase if you connected from one phase to neutral. Okay. Star and rotor winding star. The rotor winding is assumed to open circuited. That means rotor winding. Rotor winding is assumed to open circuited open circuited so that rotor current is equal to zero. So that rotor current is equal to zero and no electromagnetic torque is developed. Yes, since the current is zero, so no electromagnetic torque is developed. No electromagnetic torque is developed. So application of three phase balance voltage at line frequency F1. Application of three phase balance voltage of three phase balance voltage at line frequency F1 at line frequency F1 that is represented by F1 the stator winding causes the production of a rotating magnetic field F1 to the stator winding causes the production of a rotating magnetic field rotating magnetic field this rotating flux causes both the stator and rotor winding this rotating flux cuts both the stator and rotor winding flux cuts both the stator cuts both the stator and a stationary rotor conductor and a stationary rotor conductor at synchronous speed. Consequently, EMF of line frequency F1 are induced in them. Consequently, EMF of line frequency F1, EMF of line frequency F1 are induced in them. F1 are induced in them. Per phase voltage of the EMF induced is given by per phase value of the EMF induced, that means per phase value of the EMF induced is given by the equation that is represented by capital E1. Yeah, I think you have to remember there EMF induced equation given for the transformer. Okay, we can just drive in the already drive in the EMF induced equation in the transformer. So just similar to that one, some another constant factor add here, just similar to that one. So just that is represented by, suppose that have you remember that one EMF induced equation for the transformer. You have to remember that means E1 for the primary winding, that means here E1 represent for the stator winding. Okay, EMF induced in the stator winding similar to the primary winding EMF induced in the transformer. Okay, so that E1, if you remember that for the transformer EMF induced equation, that is nothing but 4.44 F N1 number of turns into phi. Okay, that means flux. So just similar to that one, you may be right here the EMF induced for the stator winding, that means E1 equal to 2√2 or maybe 4.4 if you multiply, then 2√2, that is directly just put here the numerical value 4.44 line frequency F1 into number of turns of the stator winding, that is represented by, suppose that here N1, okay, stator winding number of turns represented by N1. So number of turns of the stator winding that is represented by N1. Okay, and flux phi. Flux phi. Okay. One more factor here we add for the, that means some constant factor KW1. Okay. KW1 that is represent winding factor. Okay. KW1 that is represent here winding factor. Winding factor KW1, or this winding factor again will be divided into this winding factor is nothing but the pitch factor into distribution factor. Okay, this winding factor is equal to, you may write product of the distribution factor into pitch factor. Okay, that things here. Similarly, for the rotor winding, EMF induced is given by similarly, the EMF induced for the EMF induced induced for rotor winding is just similar to that one that is represented by E2, is it not? So E2 winding is same, so that is E2 equal to 4.44 KW2, that means winding factor for the rotor winding. So 4.44 KW2 F1, number of turns N2 for the stator winding, if so N2 into flux phi. Into flux phi. Okay. Where phi is your flux per pole average value, is not? But in a transformer, you may be used for maximum flux, means phi maximum. But here the flux value is in average of the average flux value of the per pole. Okay. So average value of flux is used here. Here KW1 and KW2 are the winding factor of the stator and rotor winding. Here KW1 and KW2 that means KW1 and KW2 are the winding factor, the winding factor of stator and rotor winding. Stator and rotor winding. And rotor winding. Similarly, N1 and N2 is your number of turns of the stator and rotor winding. Number of turns of the stator and rotor winding. Okay. So just we stop here, and in the next class we will continue from this point.